like to start off with a rather long quote that I believe is still relevant to this day. Even though large tracts of Europe and many old and famous states have fallen or may have fallen into the grip of the Gestapo and all the odious apparatus of Nazi, we shall not flag or fail. We shall go on to the end. We shall fight in France. We shall fight on the seas and oceans. We shall fight with growing confidence and growing strength in the air. We shall defend our island, whatever the cost may be. We shall fight on the beaches. We shall fight on the landing grounds. We shall fight in the fields and in the streets. We shall fight in the hills. We shall never surrender. And even if, which I do not for a moment believe, this island or a large part of it were subjugated and starving, then our empire beyond the seas, armed and guarded by the British fleet, would carry on the struggle until in God's good time, the new world with all its power and might steps forth to the rescue and the liberation of the old. Those words were spoken in a speech by Winston Churchill at the House of Commons on June 4th, 1940, during which time the Nazi invasion of France was taking place, and it was the ultimate show of defiance in the face of tyranny, in which Great Britain was not going to be subjugated to Nazi rule. Fast forward 75 years and the world is a much different place, but our enemies remain the same, and their intentions remain the same as well, to strike fear in the hearts of many in order to achieve their goal. As we know, 2 weeks ago, the Paris attacks, which claimed the lives of 130 people, which have been the deadliest attacks in France since World War II, and have claimed the lives of 130 people and have also injured 368 according to sources. To those who have become victims of such senseless violence, wherever you may be in the world, you have not been forgotten, nor will you ever be. To those who have underestimated the power of the Islamic State of Iraq and Syria, the rise of an ISIS is a great threat to the freedom of the world, an enemy that is well-trained, well-educated, well-determined, and most of all, fearless of death, is definitely a threat that must be taken seriously. I will say this, any religion or belief that preaches hatred, division, murder, tyranny, or terrorism, or all of the above, is not a legitimate religion or a legitimate belief, but rather a mental illness that plagues its victims. Yet there are still voices who say that if Islam did not exist, the world would be a much peaceful place. And there are those who say that if religion did not exist, the world would be a much more progressive place to live. I imagine a better world, a world in which people of all faiths, all races, and all creeds can come together in the name of progress, unity, and peace for the betterment of mankind. A world in which fear does not cripple the faithful, a world in which hatred is overcome with love. And to the President of France, who declared that the Paris attacks are a war on France, I say to you, President Francois Hollandale, that this is not just a war against France. This is not just a war against Europe and the United States, and not just a war against the free world, but a war that must be won. And to the President of the United States, President Barack Obama, with 1 year left in office, if there is one last thing that you should do as president, and I think the American people and citizens of the free world would agree with me, is this: take down ISIS. A message to the leadership of ISIS is this: history has shown us that evil in any form, whether it be the fascists of Nazi Germany, the communists of the Soviet Union, or the terrorists of Al-Qaeda, have never and will never have a permanent foothold on God's good earth, as long as there are good people willing to stand up up in defiance against the base of tyranny. Pray for Paris, pray for the world, pray for him.